Welcome to worship for All Saints Sunday. Let us pray. God of all people, from every tribe and language, you called true witnesses who sang your praise, lived your grace, and worked for peace. May we share their faith and live by their example so that we might be a blessing to the hunger of your world through Jesus Christ, whose body we are. Amen. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with thy spirit.
Almighty God,
unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Glory be to God on high. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose people are knit together in one holy church, the mystical body of your Son, grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb are the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they were persecuted, the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of Christ.
I speak to you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed are the upside down. The section of the Gospel we heard read today is called the Beatitudes. In the Beatitudes, Jesus teaches and revalues those who are devalued by society and turns societal values on their head. Christian writer, professor, and Anglican priest Barbara Brown Taylor, in her book Gospel Medicine, tells how when she was a child, she would often stand on her head to look at the world in a new way. The swing set became a letter Y instead of an A, and the grass became an endless horizon of green. It's a good image for understanding today's gospel reading. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus offers good news in the form of the Beatitudes and turns the world's values on their head. Those considered without value are given value and meaning. Have you ever felt demeaned, undervalued, without worth? Jesus teaches that a person's worth does not come from power, position, or authority, or society even, but from God. You are precious in God's sight. In the musical Dear Evan Hansen, there's a beautiful song called You Will Be Found, and the lyrics begin like this. Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear, like you could fall and no one would hear? Well, let that lonely feeling wash away. Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay, because when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand, and oh, someone will come running, and I know they'll take you home. The Beatitudes seem paradoxical because they declare the blessedness of those who are typically considered disadvantaged or marginalized in society. Jesus revalues those who are typically devalued by society. Blessed are the upside down. The gospel brings the word of hope for us. Jesus focuses his Sermon on the Mount on the kinds of people who are his target: the poor, the lame, the blind, the people who he will be ministering to and teaching. A few verses before this in Matthew's gospel, we've heard stories of people being cured by Jesus, people coming from all over to be healed by Jesus. And these are the people Jesus is focusing on. Blessed are the saints. That's you. And the witness of the saints gives us hope. This will help us to manage our lives during trying times of crises and to move into the future with Christ, because the church is the body of Christ. And you are that body in the world, and you have so many gifts to share. In her book, Gospel Medicine, Barbara Brown Taylor focuses on the idea that these blessings are upside down from the world's perspective. She offers us wisdom that these blessings challenge societal norms and values by emphasizing the worth and significance of those who are poor, or the poor in spirit, the mourning, meek, hungry, merciful, pure in heart, peacemakers, or those persecuted for righteousness' sake. She encourages us to reconsider our understanding of what it means to be blessed and to recognize the divine in the midst of life's difficulties. These paradoxical blessings are actually opportunities for spiritual growth. A person's value comes not from society, but from God. The New Testament word blessed is difficult to translate into English. And according to biblical scholar Osvaldo Vina, blessed is honorific language. It can be translated as how honorable, or how full of honor, or how honor-bringing, etc. Contrary to dominant social values, these blessed are statements ascribe honor to those unable to defend their position, or those who refuse to take advantage or trespass on the position of others. Obviously, then, the honor granted comes from God, not from the usual social sources. And Dr. Michael Hare, in his commentary on the Gospel of Matthew, translates it as happy, but not in the sense of being happy as in a fleeting kind of thing. The happiness that the blessed have is a happiness that is derived from God. For instance, we could say, how fortunate are the poor in spirit? And the other way to look at it would be to say, rather than being self-satisfied, focused on what I have done, focused on my privilege, the blessed are those who are more satisfied as God satisfies them. That is this kind of blessed. So when Jesus says, blessed are the poor in spirit, he's talking about a particular kind of person who's not dejected or dispirited, but it's something else. Blessed are the poor in spirit refers to those who manifest the attitude or the spirit appropriate to their condition, namely humble dependence on God. And very often when we look at the Beatitudes and say, hey, you know what, Jesus? This isn't how I see the world. You know, the 1%, they're pretty self-satisfied. Do the meek really inherit the earth? Well, yes, Jesus says, the meek will inherit the earth. For instance, the ones who are blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. You're a blessing to so many people. Blessed are the merciful. And if you've ever been forgiven, this is one of the most beautiful things to be forgiven. Barbara Brown Taylor speaks of going to church on Sunday, just regular Sunday stuff, and feeling just washed through and through in the prayers and in the music and in the community. And this reminds us so much of our baptism. Blessed are the pure in heart. And according to author the Kierkegaard, the pure in heart are those who can focus on God. You see, they will see God. Blessed are you, peacemakers. You are such a blessing to people. And you are children of God. Especially if you're persecuted for righteousness' sake. If you do the right thing and speak the truth to someone in power, you really are a blessing because we all have to stand up for what is right. Especially when we're talking about people standing up to the abuse of those who hold political office or are in any position of authority. Blessed are those who are infused, surrounded, who dwell in the Spirit of God. God gives us courage in the face of our challenges of today, the climate crisis, political crises, the healthcare crisis, and housing crisis. What the Lord seeks from us is to do justice, to embrace loving kindness, and to walk intentionally and deliberately with our God. The walk of faith is a deliberate and carefully chosen walk. And the Beatitudes describe this way of intentional discipleship. We need only look to the witness of the saints, both past and present, who give us hope now to carry on into the future with Christ. So, for instance, as you read through the Gospels, there are so many people who have responded to the love of Christ and chose to follow him. When you read through the Acts of the Apostles, we encounter all kinds of people who have responded to the love of Christ and chose to follow him, even though they didn't know him personally. I recommend choosing one Gospel and reading that as well as the book of the Acts of the Apostles if you haven't yet done so. And think about which of the disciples do you identify with in the Gospel? And remember that the word saint refers not only to biblical persons, but to all Christians. That's the original meaning of the word. The gift of the witness of the saints really is a blessing, and it really does help us to get through those difficult times. So how do we live it out in our lives? What do we need to do? Well, I want you to recall who has inspired you on your journey of discipleship, and what was it about them that attracted you to their life and their connection to Christ. Whatever that is, pray it, live it, and you're a blessing. And I think of Father Ruel, who was a Dominican priest. I knew him from when I lived with the Dominican fathers on Grande Allée in Quebec City. What a man of prayer, what a beautiful soul. You could see Christ's love shining out and warming you from his beautiful eyes. He just loved all the students who lived there. He loved all the people in his community. One day, I would like to be as loving and humble as Father Ruel. So we all need to think about this kind of thing and pray about it and continue to live it because the Spirit is in you, building you up on this great foundation of all the saints. So your homework this week, other than the Gospel and Acts, do that over time, but recall who has inspired you on your journey of discipleship, and what was it about them that attracted you to their life and extension, the life of Christ? Whatever that is, pray it, practice it, live it. We all need to do this so that others will see our witness And so our lives can help bring others to seek Christ and in seeking to find Christ. The walk of faith is a deliberate and carefully chosen walk which leads to blessedness. God has blessed us in Christ so that we can become a blessing to others. The witness of the saints, both past and present, gives us hope now to carry on into the future with Christ. Blessed are the upside down. Amen. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, through whom all things are made, who for us is for our salvation.
In communion with all the saints, in every time and place, let us offer our prayers to the God of love. God of the dawn chorus, for the rising sun, mist on the water, the quiet breeze and gentle snowfall, for trees still splendid with their autumnal colors, we thank you. For the promise of harvest contained within a seed, we thank you. For the oak tree within an acorn, the bread within a grain, the apple within a pip, the mystery of nature, gift wrapped for us to sow, we thank you. Kindle our will to be caring of creation, that all may have life. For those who minister in this and every Christian community, that they may find strength for their tasks and be true to their call to service, we pray that we might be a place of hope in action, hope that looks for the good in people, hope that draws its power from a deep trust in God, hope that responds to problems big and small. Let us pray for hope in action. May we be a true, engaging, glad, and active parish doing God's will, that all may have life. For all people in the midst of war. O God, you love each of us in equal and abundant measure. Yet we sometimes choose not to see ourselves in one another. We sometimes choose to live as though we are not the brothers and sisters we know ourselves to be. Pour your blessings upon all people in every nation where there is war and conflict, especially in Ukraine, Gaza, Israel, and Haiti. Preserve their lives and deliver them from the terror of war. Guide those with power in the way of reconciliation and peace instead of dominance and annihilation. Bring for all of us a deepening sense of our oneness in the human family, that those things that unite your people may be seen and felt as greater than anything that can ever divide us. That all may have life. We thank God for those who tend the sick, accompany the frustrated, visit the lonely, comfort the dying, or minister to any in need. We pray for the sick, for those in hospital, for all who suffer in mind and body, that they may be granted wholeness and health. For all those known to us and all on our parish list, that all may have life. We pray for our families and friends and hold them before you in our thoughts. We bring before you our own particular petitions. With confidence, we share these with you, for you are the God who lives among us, that all may have life. On this Feast of All Saints, may all of us follow with joy and simplicity the great throng of people who have gone before us, some with steady strides, others stumbling and wandering, but finding their way back to God, who is the way, that all may have life. Circle us, O God, encircle us with your presence. Keep joy within, keep bitterness out. Keep generosity within, keep greed out. Keep love within, keep self-seeking out. Keep light within, keep darkness out. May the love of life fill our hearts. May the love of earth bring joy to heaven. May the love of self deepen our souls. May the love of our neighbor heal our world. As nations, as peoples, this day may the love of life heal our world. Amen.
Your comfortable words, our Savior Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him, come unto me, all that are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead the new life, walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God. Almighty God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Holy and mighty God, we give you thanks for the triumph of Christ in the lives of all his saints. Receive all we offer you this day and help us, like them, to run our course with faith, that we may come to your eternal kingdom. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so
to do. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, Creator and preserver of all things, who in the multitude of thy saints has compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, that we, rejoicing in their fellowship, may run with patience the race that is set before us, and together with them may receive the crown of glory that fadeth not away. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Glory.
Blessing and glory and thanksgiving be unto thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memorial of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. When the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, we thy humble servants with all thy holy church, remembering the precious death of thy beloved Son, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again in glory, do make before thee in this sacrament of the holy bread of eternal life and the cup of everlasting salvation, the memorial which he hath commanded.
We praise thee, we bless thee, we thank thee, and we pray to thee, Lord our God.
And we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And we pray that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, all we who are partakers of this Holy Communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Let us pray. O Lord of hosts, we praise your glory reflected in your saints. May we who share at this table be filled with the joy of your eternal kingdom, where Jesus is Lord, now and forever. Amen. Glory to God.
Whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day and always. Amen. Amen.
Go forth into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.